Hey guys, Tom here from FXhome by Artlist, and today we're doing something a little bit different. We figured it's been a while since we did a VFX-y sort of motion graphics type thing, but we also wanted to do something where it's a little bit slowed down and you can follow along with us. So today I'm going to show you how to do a minimalistic long-formed shadow in HitFilm. So open up your favorite editor and compositor and follow along with me. If you enjoy this format of tutorials, then please let us know by giving this video a like, commenting down below, and subscribing if you're not already. It really helps us out, and we'll be sure to do more of them. So this is what we're going to be working on today, this nice minimalistic graphic that you can use for YouTube openings or maybe like the start of an animated film. They look great. What we're going to be doing is a couple of things that relate to 3D. So we are going to be extruding some text, creating some geometry, and then producing a light and shadow in order to create this effect. Without any further ado, let's just jump into it. I have a new composite shot already set up and open. And first thing that we're going to do is create a plane layer. And I'm just going to name this background. White is probably not going to be the best for showing where the light is going to be later on. So let's add some color into it. That way we know exactly what we're doing with our light. So I'm going to add a gradient effect. I mean, you can add whatever you want and fully customize what background you're going to be doing. I'm going to apply a quick gradient and change the blend mode to normal and set the color. Let's go with a nice little pink and then go with a orange. And then there we go, cool, looking very nice. And I'm just gonna move these into place similar to what we had in our previous one. Looks good, let's add some text. New layer, text, and let's just name this shadows. And I'm just gonna change the font type as well, just something that kind of fits what we need. It's gonna be a lot easier if your text is blockier. I mean, you can space it out, but be prepared that your shadows aren't gonna blend into one. This right here is actually the foundation. It looks pretty good on its own, but we don't have any 3D data at all really to play with. So the first thing that we're gonna do is extrude our text. So we basically need something to stand in the way of our light to create a shadow. Right now the text is flat in 3D space, so we need to give it that information. We're gonna be doing this by going into the effects window, and let's just type in extrude. And you will find this in the geometry folder. Let's apply that onto our text, and you'll see already it's kind of popped it out. There's no detail in there from a light source, so it's gonna look kind of weird and misshaped and blocky. Now that we have the extrude effect on, we can actually change the direction of which the extrusion is going by changing it to back or front, but I'm gonna change the type to front, just so it's extruding from where our text is created rather going into our background. You can also play around with the depth if you want to, but I'm going to actually just keep this at 50. With that set up, let's now add in our light. Go to new layer and down to light. Cool. And automatically we've added in a brand new camera, so we don't need to worry about that. And we can move around our light source. You can see that the extrude effect is now working. We can see that we've created some 3D geometry that we can now start playing around with in order to create our shadows. So I'm gonna move it over here for now and just kind of leave it around that. That looks like it would probably create a nice even shadow judging by the darkness in the W and S. Now, in order for our light to cast a shadow, we actually need to enable that feature. So if we go into our light properties and we can find cast shadows here and enable that right away. Nothing's happened right now, I know. It's okay. So now that our light source can cast the shadows, we need to now tell our objects to emit shadows and also capture them. Let's go to our text and background plane and go to the layer dimensions icon and switch this to 3D plane. We can see it particularly on our background plane. If I start moving around, that is where our light source is. So we can move that and it gets wider and bigger. However, we still don't have a shadow. What we need to do is tell our layers to emit those shadows. Now that we have everything 3D, we can go into our text layer, choose materials, and then go on to cast shadows. Now this right here is a good title design. In fact, Moon Knight has something very similar to this effect, but you're not here for that. You're here for that minimalistic graphic look. So let's figure out how we can do that. Now bear with me because we're actually gonna be undoing a couple of things that we've done previously to make this less 3D. The first thing that we're gonna do is go into our background plane and turn off Illuminated. This gets rid of the light affecting our background. Now, the problem that we're facing is that our extrude effect is causing the shadow, but also bulging out our text. We want to keep the shadow, but remove the geometry. Like with our background, we're going to go into Illuminated and turn that off for now. And that looks pretty good on its own, but there is still some depth to our text. What we're instead going to do is grab our text, duplicate it by pressing Ctrl and D. And what we're going to do this time in the materials is switch everything off. And then the last thing that we're going to do is go into the geometry and turn off that extrude effect. And now we're back to where we started. The text is flat, but we still have that shadow. Then from here, it's a case of just moving around the shadow, maybe even keyframing some movement so it can move across or move down in width and show the scale of which the shadow is growing. This is a great opening title for something like a time-lapse video, like, you know, you're showing that passage of time as things are moving. And if you're not a fan of the hard edges, then what you can do is go into your light settings and maybe play around with the opacity and diffusion. The diffusion will just soften those edges so you can have some really nice lighting. Awesome job following along with the tutorial. I really do hope that has been helpful for you. If you are planning to use this title design, let us know in the comment section what you're working on. We'd love to know. That's it for this week's video, but if you're looking for more, might I suggest the video beside me, or better yet, subscribe to the channel and you'll never miss a single video that we do. So I'll see you in the next video.